and Terri McWilliams.
And I'm Ted McWilliams.
So, as you can see, we lost our home in the tornado, and we just really want what we share today to just encourage you and encourage you that God's always there. And so what Steve mentioned us talking about is just showing where God really, we really saw God through this whole process. And so as I was praying about what to share, I pulled out my journal, and on February 23rd, I had specifically written a prayer just for Ethan's protection and just for his future and that and what God has planned for him and his future. And so that's been emotional for me to look back at that prayer and know that that night of the tornado, that he was the one that had to dive down the stairs as the roof was blowing off, and as he was, and as the walls were falling. And so I just think that was an answered prayer, that the Lord takes our prayers, and he wants good for us. And another way that I know that God was with us that night was when I was trying to figure out what to do, because Ted wasn't home with us. I was looking at my phone, trying to figure out, is it really bad? You know, weighing that out, and just the strong, not fear, but authoritative voice of go, get your children and go. And I know that that was the Lord guiding us to safety that night.
Yeah, I wasn't here the night it happened. I was on a business down in Chattanooga, and when I got back, you know, of course, everything impacted. You worry on the way back, and the thoughts and everything going through my mind. But getting here and seeing this, you know, I've heard a lot of people, you know, on the radio and talking about this and other things, and they say, why would God do this? And, you know, it's just, there's a very, very intense, quiet confidence that I have, and I think we both have, and our family has, is God didn't do this. I mean, this, we live in a broken world, and He will take what happens in this world, and He will make it, you know, good come out of it, incorporate it into His plan for us and such, you know, in the best way possible, because His is the best plan and stuff. But just, you know, I'd been just kind of in the back of my mind a little bit of sour in the year and so leading up to this event and stuff, just because of the political spectrum and all the stuff that's going on and you know, online and that you see. And I was just kind of like, you know, my faith in humanity is just disappearing. And then this happened. And, you know, the day afterwards and the, excuse me, and the cleanup and everything, just seeing, I don't know, a couple hundred, 250 people out here cleaning up. Most of them I probably didn't even know, just coming to be the hands and feet of Christ, you know, that really, really boosted my faith in humanity again. You know, you just kind of get soured, and that all happened, and it was wondrous. And I looked at it from the perspective of, these are people here, you know, that I know to help, or just people who wanted, who didn't know me and didn't know us, to help. And I realized, aside from you know, God taking what happened and showing us you know, how loving and kind and helpful people can be, it was also an opportunity for people to be the hands and feet of Christ. And you know, I was, and we were all very blessed to see that happen right here on our property and stuff. And so, just kind of a renewed faith in humanity. You know, I don't look at this happening as, I know God didn't do it. I have, you know, like I said, that confidence. But He took it, and he made a lot of good things come out of it. And there's still that tragedy that people are going to think about, and the memory they have to bear of this. And if they went through it, you know, whatever, you know, whatever that looks like for them. But I can see the good that can come from this, and that people have come closer together. They were able to, you know, reach out and help. Some people just feel helpless, and they're like, I prayed for you. And that's fantastic. If that's all you can do, man, do it, and just keep on doing it. But so many were just out here and supportive and stuff. It was good to see that come out of that event, that kind of goodness and that kind of, you know, just the hands and feet of Christ at work. It was phenomenal. It was great.
Looking back through my journal, when collision when we went to TCTC in January, the whole topic for the weekend was wilderness, being in the wilderness. And I feel like that is so applicable for all of us right now, whether you're a victim of a tornado or you're dealing with just the fear and uncertainty of COVID-19, or you're dealing with personal things in your life. But I just, this, I feel like that night that we climbed out of our basement, there was total darkness. There was no lights, nothing. And it made me think about that's what the wilderness is. And it's hard. The wilderness is hard. And I don't, if you go camping, that's the closest I can think of pitch dark and seeing the stars. And I think it's important for all of us to have hope and to look for the stars in this season. And I want to be able to look back because it is hard and it feels dark. But I want to be faithful in looking back and have seen the stars. And so I think for all of us, as we walk through all this uncertainty, that we just lean in and press in to the Lord, and we pray like we've never prayed before.
One other thing that happened just recently is the tornadoes in Sparta. But I was always looking already, you know, where, how can I return that? How can I, you know, be more of the hands and feet of Christ like we all should be? And so that tornado that came through Sparta just this past weekend, of course, you know, we got the call that trees were down, houses were damaged. I just felt this energy and stuff. It's like, hey, let's go help. Now's the time. So we were able to get down there, do a lot of, you know, chainsaw cutting, help people clear, just return the favor, and just that receiving it, and then also able to be just almost immediately afterwards, you know, 2 or 3 weeks afterwards, to be the hands and feet of Christ and go help others in the same manner. I tell you, it was empowering to do so. It was fulfilling to do so. And just, you know, looking for the opportunity to do so again. Hopefully it's not anything, you know, of levels of tragedy that nobody wants to go through, but just opportunities to do that in everyday life. Looking forward to doing that more and more. So a lot of good things came out of this, you know, this part of this broken world that we had to go through. And, you know, I hope everybody has the opportunity to find that light that's in the darkness, in the wilderness, and just help others throughout whatever they're going through as well.